As someone with a background in energy, I can assure you that Pennsylvania's governor recognizes the importance of developing our energy resources in a responsible manner. He knows that the energy play has the potential to be a real game changer, not only for Pennsylvania, but for our nation. But it's fitting that you chose Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, as the location of this summit. You see, Pennsylvania has a rich energy history. In 1859, about 100 miles to the north of here, the world's first commercially successful oil well was drilled in Titusville, ushering in a new era in energy production to change the course of civilization. Fast forward to the 1920s, where Pennsylvania had over 400,000 people working underground in the coal and clay mines. And as a state, we accounted for 25% of the world's energy output. At that time, Pennsylvania led the nation in steel, coal, and cement production. And were our economy a standalone economy, Pennsylvania would have been the fourth largest economy in the world. Fast forward again to the present. Once again, Pennsylvania is at the center of an energy revolution that can help clear the path to energy independence. To put this into perspective, think about this. Pennsylvania is home to the second largest energy field in the world, with more BTU energy equivalent of natural gas in the state than Saudi Arabia has in oil. To further drill this down, Pennsylvania went from importing 75% of its natural gas only 5 years ago to becoming a net exporter of gas in June of 2011 for the first time in 100 years. Now, we hear the words energy independence a lot, but again, not a lot of people comprehend the magnitude of our dependence on energy that's not produced in the United States. So let's put this into relative terms. The enacted Pennsylvania budget for the current fiscal year is $27.656 billion. Currently, the United States spends nearly $25 billion a month on foreign oil. So that gives you an idea of the magnitude of what our imports of foreign oil are. To me, that's implausible, and we can put an end to this practice once and for all if we develop our resources right here at home.